Hello friends, greetings from Professor M.I. Vyas. We are continuously learning engineering graphics, which is the language for engineers, and it is a universal language. We have already learned the various aspects of the orthographic projections. Today we are going to learn sectional orthographic projections, where we cut an object at any from any point, and when we remove some part of the object, how does it interpret, how does it look, that we will draw. So let us see what is the fundamentals involved in orthographic projections of that sectional orthographic. In orthographic projections, details of the object which are not visible from outside are shown by means of dotted line or dashed line. So friends, here we are using a different line, that is dotted line or dashed line. For what? The details of the object which are not visible from outside are shown by means of dotted line or dashed line. When the object is complex from inside, there will be many dotted lines in the projections. It will be difficult to interpret or read the projections of such object when there are too many dotted lines inside the projections. So suppose the complex object is given, and inside, if you draw the inside of that complex object, it is number of dotted lines which makes the drawing very difficult to read or interpret. So that you will see how to draw. Orthographic projection of such a complex object is drawn after imaging it as an object cut by an imaginary cutting plane parallel to the principal plane, passing through the details of the object. See what it says, the object is cut through the imaginary. See, we have already discussed throughout this subject that engineering graphics, there you have to develop the imagination. Imagination is very, very important. And once again here, in a sectional orthography, you have to imagine that object is being cut. Actually, it is not cut. You have to imagine by imaginary cutting plane parallel to the principal plane, and that passing through the details of the object. An imaginary by which the object is cut is known as cutting plane or a section plane. So this is the new term that is pertaining to the sectional orthographic projection. What is cutting plane or what is section plane? An imaginary plane which cut the object, that is cutting plane. Projection of cut object is known as sectional projection or a sectional view. Projection of cut object is known as sectional view or a sectional projection. Portion of the object between cutting plane and an observer is imagined to be removed, and then the object is viewed by the observer and projection is drawn. You just read with little patience. Try to understand what it says. Portion of the object between the cutting plane and an observer. So when we are observing, when we are viewing the object, and the cutting plane, which is an imaginary plane, cut the object, that you have to, that object, that part of the object is to be removed, and then the object is viewed. Then you have to see how the object is viewed. That object you have to project, and the projection of that object you have to draw. Dotted or dashed lines are omitted in the sectional projection. This is very important. Dotted or dashed lines are omitted in the sectional projection. Generally, one view is drawn sectional. We have seen last time that when an object is given, we are drawing generally front view, top view, and either a left-hand side view or right-hand side view. So when we are viewing the object, we are drawing the three view. Out of that, generally one view is drawn sectional view. Only cutting plane line is shown to locate the section, and arrows are drawn to show the direction of sight. Only cutting plane line is shown to locate the section, and arrows are drawn to show the direction of sight. This is how the cutting plane line we can show. It is a dotted line. Cutting plane line known as a line of section or a traces of the cutting line. So that cutting line is shown with the dotted line, and at both end we can show the arrow. The direction of the arrow shows that we are viewing from these directions. So in this, the arrow is at downward, that means we are viewing from the top. We are viewing from the top and looking at the downward, and how does the object looks. So if we have to draw the sectional view in such case, then we have to show the sectional top view. We have to show the section line in the top view. The elements of the object cut by cutting plane is made evident by drawing hatching lines in them. Dear friends, I must say that, or I understood that during the beginning of this subject, when you studied the lettering, dimensioning, you have already studied the hatching line, where it can be used. The hatching line is used in the sectional orthographic. Hatching lines are thinner than boundary lines and drawn at 45 degrees spaced at about 2 to 3 mm apart. See, this is the rules that you have to follow. Hatching lines are thinner than the boundary lines and draw at a 45 degree spaced at about 2 to 3 mm apart. The cutting plane need not be continuous but may be offset or turned through an angle. It is not the need not be continuous, it is offset. So we have seen some of the fundamentals, the term associated with the sectional orthographic, how we have to look and how to draw that. Now we will see. First, I will show you a few figures where the section we have put, a very simple object, cutting plane, section we took, and the sectional view. See, look at the figure. The section, this one, an object is given. The object you see carefully. What is the object? The object is this. This is one component of the machine. This is the cylinder portion and this is the bracket. Now, this is the cutting plane. See, this dotted, this entire, this rectangle which you are showing, this is the cutting plane. This plane is imaginary. See, this plane is imaginary that cuts an object. The plane cuts an object through this line at this axis. This is the axis through which the plane cuts, the plane cuts from here and the object get cut through this line. So this is the cutting plane, this is the cutting line that we have shown here. It starts from here A and up to here this A. Friends, once again I am repeating what I detect in my slides. This is the cutting plane, the dotted rectangle plane. This cutting plane is imaginary. You are viewing from the top. We are cutting this object from the middle of this. When we cut, the cutting plane passes through this line, which AA. This is AA. Now, what is the guiding principles? When there is a cutting plane, you have to imagine that this object, the part of the object, the portion of the object between the observer, or observer is here in top, object is here, this you have to remove, this portion you have to remove. So this portion, assume that you are removing this portion, the dotted which I am putting, these dots, you have to assume that is removing. When we are removing this, and when you are viewing from the top, the half of the object look like this. See, the half of the object look like this. This is the bottom half portion of the object. This is the bottom half portion of the object. See, and when you are viewing from here, and the front view is from here. Front view is from here. This is the direction X. Front view is from here. For the top view, you are viewing from here. This is the top view you are viewing. So, when you are viewing from this X, suppose if I have been asked to draw the sectional view, I can show the sectional view only in this top view, because the section plane, the cutting plane is parallel to the HP. This cutting plane is parallel to the HP. So when I'm viewing, I can show the sectional view in the top. So the section I can show only in top view, as the cutting plane is parallel to the HP. So if I have been asked to draw the front view and sectional top view, front view and sectional top view, how does it look? Let us see. When I am viewing here, this is the object, this is the inner diameter of the cylinder, this is the inner diameter of the cylinder that I am drawing, this is the recess is given, this is the outer diameter at a certain thickness, outer diameter is this, and this is the recess, the gap at this end. When I am viewing here, this projection, this end is look like this. From here, it comes here, here, and here. So, here. This is the front view of this given object when I'm viewing from here. Now, see, the cutting plane is this. So, it cuts the object through horizontally, means it is parallel to the HP. You have to draw the cutting plane line in a front view. See here, the dark, this end and this end, these two are the little dark end, the bright end, and we are viewing from the top. We are viewing from the top. You have to show arrow from this direction, arrow looking to the downward. So, because we are viewing from the top, the section looks from here, whatever we draw, that how does it look from here? We have to give the name of that section plane. So it is AA, it is written here. How do we write? Put AA, it is here. AA here. Now, See, when we are cutting this plane, you can see we have to assume that this dotted portion that is between the observer and an object, this we have to remove. We have to remove this. After removing, the top view looks like this. So in this is the real object and the top view look like this. This is the curvature, looks the straight line on both the side, it is straight line. Now we have to show the hatching, the section line as per the rules. So where we will show the hatching? It is this. This portion, the material where when we cut the object, cutting plane touch here and the material get removed or it passes here. This is the portion where the cutting plane passes through and touch this object. So this, after finishing the top view, you have to draw this hatching line at a 45 degree which ends here. Remember, the rule says at both the end, and the hatching line end always with the full line. It is always with the full line. If the cutting plane is not given, what would be the my top view or top view of this portion? If cutting plane is not there, then this portion, the top view would be like this. This is the center line, and inside this two is like a dotted line. This is the top view in case when there is no section cut through this, only this portion. I have projected only this in that case. But here we have cut this, so this imaginary that we have to assume it is removed. So this, and when you cut, it becomes a full line. This particular dotted line becomes a full line. This you also visible, so it also become a full line. So this is how when you cut an object, it does look. How does it look? We take one more problem. Let us see another object where cutting planes are given. You see, this is the object. This is the pictorial view of an object. See, this object is symmetry to this axis and this axis. The object is symmetry to the x-axis and to the y-axis. See, so when you see, this is the front view. When we are viewing from this direction, this is your front view. Front view looks like this. Now, when you cut this, when the cutting plane passes through this y axis, which is means passes through this, it is parallel to the VP. The cutting plane would be parallel to the VP. Imagine that half of this portion you are removing. This portion between the from this observer and here, it removed. When you are viewing from this left side of this, how does it look? It looks like this. It looks like this. And this is the portion. Here it is a material through which the cutting plane passes. So here you have to show the hatching line. Here you have to show the hatching line. And when you are showing the hatching line, naturally, as per the rules, this should be the full line. Otherwise, in a normal left-hand side view, this would become a dotted line. These two would be the dotted line. But we have assumed that this portion we are removing. When you are viewing from here, when the cutting plane is AA, What it says, when the cutting plane is AA and you are viewing from here, the side view looks like this. So the left hand side view shown here, this left hand side view is shown here. This is the sectional left hand side view. This shows the sectional left hand side view. Now, when you are cutting an object through this axis, which is parallel, the cutting plane is parallel to the HP, and you are viewing from the top, and you are viewing from the top. You assume that this portion of an object is removing, so the balance half of the bottom half of an object look like this. When we are viewing from the top, the bottom half look like this. This is the section line that one has to draw, or this is the material through which the cutting plane pass and it is removed. So when you are viewing from the top, the sectional top view looks like this. You have to show the hatching line at a 45 degree, 2 to 3 mm apart from each other. Both end, this end of the hatching line should always have a full line. The end of this always have a full line. How to show the cutting plane in your view? Cutting plane is AA. You have to draw the line, dotted line from here to here, and you are viewing from here, so put the arrow in these directions and mark AA. That means the object is cut through AA. Second cutting plane is this BB. This is the BB, cuts horizontally, means parallel to the HP, and when you are viewing from the top, put the cutting line here and show by this arrow downward, so that we are looking from the top, and in that case the sectional top view looks like this. See here, the object get cut by the two plane. So you have shown that both the plane, cutting plane AA and cutting plane BB, in front view. Now when the object get cut through AA, it looks that sectional side view in this form. The sectional side view is in this form. You can also show the cutting plane, another cutting plane here, section BB. This BB you can show. Similarly, when this BB cutting plane you are looking from, you are viewing from the top, this is the sectional top view. You can show the section AA, that is also in this view. This is just nothing but you have to show, or how you can show the cutting plane in the view, so that the sectional view based on this cutting plane, you can draw. So friends, I hope you have understood what is the cutting plane, how does we can show it, and how does the particular sectional view look like. Further in the continuation, let us see one few more typical objects in this. Once again, this is one machine element. You can now imagine that this is the 1/4 portion that is being cut and removed. If suppose there were no cut, it would be a complete cylinder that you can see. This is the 3D view. In this 3D view of an object, one cut means from here to here, the cutting plane and the object is removed. When you are viewing from the here, that is in front view direction X. This is the front view direction X. In that case, the front view would be look like this. The front view would be look like this. Now, when you cut an object in this particular manner, when you cut, suppose when you are viewing here, from here, these two portions get removed, and this is the material through which the cutting plane pass. This is the material through which the cutting plane pass. So you have to show the section over here. Suppose if the section would be like this, full sectional from here, if this get cut, and when we are viewing from here, and this another portion get removed, the full sectional front view would like this. See, if there is no section, in that case, this inner hole of this cylinder and these two hole in this base, we usually show by this dotted line. But when it is a full sectional in this fashion, from here to here, also imagine this portion also get removed, this portion also get removed. In that case, only this half left out. So the sectional front view would be look like this. These dotted lines becomes full line, this dotted line becomes full line, and this dotted line also becomes a full line. And suppose instead of full sectional view, if sometimes we have to only see the half sectional view, the same half section view you can show in this manner, only half of this, remaining half you are not drawing. This is the top view, a normal top view of this when we are viewing from the here. This is the front view. In that case, top view would be in this manner. So we have drawn this top view, and the cutting plane in that case is shown by this line, this complete line, and the arrow are here, AA. This is the section plane cuts, which is from here parallel to the VP, and when you are viewing from this front, the sectional view look like this. The sectional view look like this. Let us see one more. See another component. There is, you can say, the cylinder, and there is a base. Inside there are four holes for riveting or fitting the nuts and bolts. When it is the plane cut through this AA and remove, this is the view in these directions, the cutting plane parallel to the VP, and when you remove these, this is the sectional front view. And suppose 1/4 of the portion remove here, that is how another plane perpendicular to this section plane AA, another plane perpendicular, that is B, only this 1/4 portion is removed. So in that case, this is the full section, this is the half section. You see the difference in full section, both the side we are viewing this section line, in half section only half. And this is the top view, and in top view we are putting this section AA over here and section B over here. This is the section B over here, this. So you can see how the sectional orthography we can draw. Until now, what we have seen some fundamentals and the sectional orthographic, how does an object look and how to draw the view of that object, how to show the section in any one view, how to show the cutting plane, how to draw the hatching, everything. Now we will solve one problems. Now see, let us take one problem and try to draw the sectional view in the orthographic of that problem. This is an object given we are viewing from here. This is the X. Draw the front view. Sectional right hand side view and top view. Use first angle system. Where is the cutting plane? Cutting plane is this. A means it passes through here and here. It cuts an object from here, so the cutting plane is parallel to the VP. It cuts the object from here, and this portion of the object we have to remove this. So let us draw first three orthographic views. When we are viewing from here, it looks like this. I'm just drawing first with the pencil with very faint drawing. Later on I will make it dark with the marker pen, so it will be visible to you. All these are as per the dimensions given. So it looks like this. This shape I have drawn with this. This bottom portion. From here it looks this. This curvature in front view as per the dimension. You cannot see these two holes in a front view, so those are dotted. Center line and then dotted. Right. So this, you can also see this particular portion, this line you can show by dotted line. This is below this, so it can be over here. Now the top view, draw the projections from the front view. Bring down all projections. This is the center line. Now you can draw the top view of a given size as per the dimensions. So make the top view with a different color so it can be visible. This is the center line. This hole you cannot see. This portion is this. Curvature becomes the straight line. Mark this hole with the dotted line. Again, this line you cannot show. Mark it, dotted line, like this. So this is your top view. Now the side view, we have to draw the sectional side view. Draw all projections from here, from the front view. This is your front view. When we are viewing from this side, this is the X. This is the right hand side view. You are looking from this side. Now, this is your right hand side. When you are viewing from here, it looks like this. So how does it look? It looks like this. Center line, from center line, it is a curvature. Mark another center. There is a hole of this size. Now take projections from here, this. So how does the right hand side view first looks? The right hand side view looks like this. This is the dotted line initially we draw. This also the dotted line. Mark this center. This is the hole. This is your right hand side view. Now when there is a cut, you have to remove this. It looks like this. In that case, you have to that sectional right hand side view. Sectional right hand side view, make this the full line, these two line full, and mark the section hatching this way. So this is your sectional right hand side view. This is the portion 1, 2, 3, 4, is this 1, 2, 3, 4. These are the 5, 6, 7, 8. This confines this section cutting line. And how does we can show that here? This is the section dotted line, mark here arrow and put AA. This AA here you can write down full sectional view along AA. This you have to mark here below this, so that we can see AA. So friends, we have learned how to show the sectional orthographic, or how to project the object when it is cut by a cutting plane. So we have learned the sectional orthographic projections, we learn the basics of that cutting plane, the cutting line, section line, that is hatching, what are the rules that you have to follow, and in a different position of the cutting plane, how does it look and how to draw the sectional view. I hope you have enjoyed and learned this session. Do more practice at home of the same of the orthographic and sectional orthography. Thank you. All the best.